Hey everybody, welcome back to Final Fantasy X-2. Okay. Time to continue our... Alright, Kilika's been taken care of. Check out what's going on in Luca. Blitzball season. Blitzball season's here at last. So, are we playing? Really?
The day that Blitz freaks across Spirit have been waiting for is finally here! That's right, folks! Blitzball season has begun!
Wow! Is it that time of year already?
I wonder if Waka and the gang are here.
The Aurochs aren't coming.
I hear they've got their hands full with babysitting.
Aww! They should have just brought the baby along!
And guess what? They want the Gullwings to compete in their place.
Are you serious? All right! I've always wanted to play Blitzball!
Hmm? Why do we have to play?
Don't sweat this small stuff! Leave everything to me!
Me!
So, are we in or what?
Sure?
I have been practicing my diving a lot. You know, you might be surprised.
I did not know you could play Blitzball. Trading and command point assignments have not changed since last practice. Are these actually going up? Man, it's 5 minutes. Spend command points to advance your players. Select a player name and allocate points to the skill you'd like them to train, different attributes of train. Players with high teamwork. What? Fuck it! Is it the same as it? Adrenaline! Shinra, you suck! What's going on? The fuck? What the fuck, Shinra? That was the wrong way! You fool! You lost it! Kill the Guado! You foolish fools! Nama. The old man Sykes just kicked everything's ass. Okay. So what, you get the command points or whatever? Argent, fun you can rely on. I'm leaving. That was... I don't know what's going on. Who wants to hear my sales pitch? Okay, fine, fuck all of you, eat dick. Does anybody want to hear my sales pitch? No? Okay. I'm a big ol' Ronso looking motherfucker. Well, shit. Well, let's go check out the Meehan High Road. Our proprietor Ridden is presenting the results of his investigations into the High Road troubles of late. Okay. Ridden is waiting outside. Argent, fun you can rely on. Find your better half. Argent, at your service.
I am glad you are all here. I would like to talk about the recent string of incidents occurring on the High Road.
Why is that still breathing? First, let us discuss the circumstances surrounding the hover crash. It seems that not everyone wants Machina around. Someone has been trying to destroy the High Road's Machina, starting with that hover. The investigation of the new road yielded a vital clue. Marks were found suggesting that something fell into the ravine below. As you have no doubt realized, someone or something pushed the hover off the road. Lady Yuna, suppose you wanted to push a hover off a cliff. How would you go about doing so? Me? I'm not strong enough. That is correct. You, Lady Yuna, are not. If you had had fiend-like strength, however, you could probably manage. In other words, the hover was attacked with extraordinary force and knocked into the ravine. Now let us consider the runaway drone Machina. But then again, perhaps runaway is not the best word. Machina don't just run amok on their own, now do they? My investigation has revealed that drone Machina did not malfunction, rather they were programmed to grow violent. Of course, it may have all been result of pure coincidence. Perhaps the guilty party merely fiddled with their own Machina's control panel after seeing someone else do the same. I'm convinced that is exactly how it all happened. I would like to call a witness. This is the pilot of the crashed hover. Surely you saw the one who pushed the hover off the new road. I see. Just as I thought.
It is clear our guilty party wanted to rid the high road of its machina. Lady Yuna, what do you think would happen if the high road no longer had any machina?
We'd probably need chocobos instead.
That is correct. Travelers would use chocobos instead of hovers. It all boils down to this. The culprit's objective, obviously, was to bring chocobos back to the high road. I recently witnessed a certain party chasing after a gull. This was no playful pursuit, but rather a sincere hunt for food by a starving creature. Hungry, it tried to devour its prey. It, of course, meaning that fiend which craves chocobos.
Kill it.
With its main course gone from the high road, the creature instinctively knew. Machina are responsible. Destroy them, and the chocobos will return. And that is when it used its formidable strength to topple the hover. Further, when it discovered the Machina's control panel, it somehow pressed the right buttons to cause the Machina to go haywire. This fiend is truly an impressive creature. It has managed to thoroughly disrupt our daily affairs, even if it was just pure luck. Fiend or not, I admire it greatly for its tenacious pursuit of its goals. In honor of that tenacity, I will use the resources available to me to return chocobos to the high road. Farewell, my friend.
What?
The chocobos deserve to live without fear of being devoured. Well, Lady Yuna, is it not pleasant to be rocked back and forth astride a chocobo?
The chocobos seem happier, with that fiend finally gone.
So, what are you gonna do with it?
Winya padan ufa chagufek.
Oh.
So, a happy ending for everyone. Unless you're a fiend.
Anywho, let's get back to the airship.
Wow, look at her go.
Wait!
Well, at least they killed it. Although, are you sure it wasn't Profit? From now on, you can ride chocobos. Talk to the hover attendant. Something about... What? I mean, I wanted to kill that fucking thing, and I'm glad it's dead. I could... It had to be Profit. I must have fucked something up. Probably better off feeding Profit to that thing and then killing it. Well, there's still treasure. Greetings. I wonder. Oh. Okay, and I think I thought maybe it was like, hey, maybe if I pick the same level on the thing, it might have a similar attitude. How that magazine feeds into the chamber. Treasure! And we killed the Bitch King. Like, hey, there's this like milquetoast motherfucker. You want to marry him? I don't know if the redneck daddy will agree with it, but you never know. Aha, I almost missed you. Trying to blend in. Curtains. It's coitins. Coitins for you. Hello. You're a thing. Akamana? Aka dead motherfucker. Oh, blind shock. Bomb cores. Treasure? Monsters? Hmm. Ooh.
So what's next?
I always hate that. It's like, the thing is dead. Well, fuck you. I'm gonna fucking hit you once more. Titanium bangle. Mithril would be better in titanium.
Never underestimate Yuna.
You, sir, I have a sales pitch for you. I think when we get to the travel agency, we'll just skip over to the, Well, fuck you too, buddy. I think we'll just warp to the next place. I could have swore it was going to be profit, though. We avoided open conflict between the Youth League and New Yevon. Now they're holding a battle tournament to blow off steam. Really? Okay, it didn't automatically send me into... I want to harass Prophet real quick. Like, at long last, our diligence has finally paid off. Yeah. I still think that you fuckers... I still think they had something to do with it. There's no way they didn't.
Resolve our conflicts with New Yevon peacefully.
The guys who went to the concert have been going around pushing for a truce.
That's great!
Sadly, there are a great many League members who don't know what to do with their energy. It may sound odd, but they're unhappy about losing the chance to fight.
They are so ready to blow up. But Commander Lucille thought of this great idea! Like, what if everybody blew off some steam with a battle tournament?
Sounds like fun.
Yuni, maybe we should enter.
That would be so cool! Yigal's handling registration, so if you're competing, talk to him.
Hmm? That may be a little... a little better than trying to do a Blitzball tournament. Although, at least in this one, the Blitzball thing doesn't quite seem as... now it just seems like you grind out numbers and boost with numbers.
You're going down!
That's the spirit.
You foolish fool! The thing I wonder is it going to be a battle tournament with just people in it, or is it going to be one of those things like, this is me and my pet fiends. Look at my pet fiends. Well, at least it's not fucking Killer Fang. How longer do you have to go before you get Ultima sandals? Then again, those flare sandals pretty much kicked everything's ass. Then again, it's not like... hey, Howl! She can double her hit points now. Battle tournament's gonna be like. Wonder if I get experience out of it. Be interesting if it's someplace I could grind. First fight is bearded beard man with a flamethrower, and he's. Okay, wait. What? The elevator's up. Fuck? The elevator's up. How can I fucking get... what the hell? What's this elevator shit? Or is it down in the pit somewhere? because that don't make no sense. It's like, yeah, go talk to Dude Batman. The elevator's up, though. She learned physicist. Ooh. Is it down here? Goddamn camera angle. Oh god. Kill it fast, kill it fast, kill it fast, kill it fast, kill it fast.
Stronger than you thought, huh?
Doesn't look like it's down here. Was he down here to talk to? Are you participating in the tournament? Well, there you are.
Will you be competing in the tournament?
Yeah.
Understood. Allow me to lead the way.
So I can't go to their headquarters anymore.
The High Summoner Yuna has graciously agreed to help test our strength. Step forward if you are confident in your skill.
Ooh, I wanna... I, too, accept the honor of entering the tournament. I will never forget the day I was allowed to challenge Lady Yuna.
Very well. All units, take your positions.
Mission time! Okay, I... Defeat the Youth League's finest in a no-holds-barred fight to the finish. You have what it takes? Commander Lucille will be the judge of that. Win 7 battles in a row.
Let the first round commence.
Huh? Well, me? May the best warrior win.
Pain just fucked your world up, buddy.
We've got bigger fish to fry.
I think she critted him.
The next challenger awaits.
Oh, nice. I walk between each one.
Lady Yuna.
You make combat look effortless.
She is beating people the fuck up with, like, some kind of festival MacGuffin. The high summoner rolls up and starts beating you with fucking party favors, and throws some sandals at you that explode in a fucking gout of non-elemental death. What fountain? I might actually throw flares at you. The not so mighty guard.
Here comes my trump card!
Okay, those damn sandals just don't seem to do anything.
Magnificent, Lady Yuna. Elma, you too fought well. Learn from this defeat.
Commander, who will be next?
What? Will no one step forward?
Well, I guess we're done.
You're forgetting someone.
Me? Lady Yuna, if I may?
I'd be honored.
The honor is mine. Please be gentle.
I don't trust you. You're gonna do something bad and evil and mean. Let me try this anyway. Actually worked.
A good match.
You really are amazing, Lady Yuna.
You are incredible too, Commander.
Elma was more of a problem than fucking Lucille was. Ooh, another muscle belt.
Now is the perfect time for me to tell you something that has been on my mind. It concerns the Youth League and Spira's future. When the calm arrived 2 years ago, it echoed deep in the hearts of Spira's youth. With Sin's defeat, we had lost not only our mortal enemy, but also our purpose in life. I too felt lost. I did not know what direction to take, where to channel my energy. It was Maven Nuge who guided our lost generation to a new purpose, to uncover Spira's true past. This is the same man who was once called Deathseeker, who made no attempt to hide his despair. What caused Maven Nuge to change? That is not for us to know. Nonetheless, under Nuge's leadership, we finally found a way to apply our strength. But look at us now. The power we hope to use for good has intoxicated us all, even Nuge. The Youth League is in danger of becoming a mindless band of thugs that know only violence. A power that destroys rather than creates, without meaning, no better than Sin. Do you remember why the Youth League seeks the truth behind Spira's past? Because Spira's past is the foundation for its future. Our power exists so that we may cut a new road to a new age. An age where children will never have to lift a sword.
Episode complete. Huh? Interesting. Anyway, I'll be right back. Okay. Oy. Had to take care of something real quick. Hmm. The faction's trump card. The machine faction has made some kind of weapon in Gibson's labs, and now they want us to drop by. Gullwing guinea pigs? Gonna go? Uh-oh. Your concert was a blast. How did that dance of yours go again? Like this? So what'd they do? They made a beat bot?
Nakinar Uchmakina Luknilde, Utfim Diki Banfeva. Wodaja we Luyim to pay drek drek.
Well now, that sounds like a dare.
He wants us to challenge their unbeatable Machina.
The Machina's power will increase if you found any assemblies in the desert. The experiment will break if defeated, but repair manuals can be used to fix it up for a rematch. Its stats are as follows. Okay. Masterpiece Seeker. Prove your strength by smashing the machine faction's masterpiece, Spear's most powerful Machina weapon. God damn! Oh, we learned Ultima Sandals, but the damn thing doesn't seem to wanna. Aww.
We really trashed him.
Tell him this.
Diga win delik yut kujai.
Mega win your daddy back. Yache rija tu fim ten kunika Machina.
Hey, he understood me.
Fiddler win Magica!
Find repair manuals and you can fight the experiment again. It's still a work in progress, so you can power it up even more, but with any special assemblies you dig up in the desert. It doesn't matter if you find these assemblies before or after the experiment's repaired. Upgrades are installed as soon as you find them. Well, we're right next to the moon flow, so... Damn it. I wonder if there's any Tobleys up to any more mischief here. Yeah, I probably need to make her stop using Mad Rush. Yeah, those things seem a lot more likely to cause status ailments and actually do what they're supposed to.
Well, well.
Take two steps, fight more monsters.
Nice knowing you.
Sure. So they got fuckers on a shoe puff. A dancing high pillow. One doing something. Okay.
Oh, how sensationally sensational! More or less.
Ain't too bad. Well. Well, we're on our way to Guado Salami, so... Oh, yeah. Oh, that was the kid. There's actually an enemy called Blackguard. Ah, it's the poison thingy. None of those things have mouths where their crotch should be. Anyway, we'll enter Guadalajara next time. Catch you later. Adios.